We have a really big show for you today. From petitions to declarations is the theme of this video. From petitioning to making declarations. That is the key for these times right now. And so this is a big shift. This is what we've been getting ready for. To go from petitioning to declarations. Petitioning is to say, help, 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 help. I'm so trapped. I'm so vulnerable. I'm so weak. I'm in so much trouble. Please, I need help, 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 help. That's petitioning. Declarations is to say, I am and time isn't, and that's it. I am and time isn't, and that's it. I don't have any problems. I am and I don't have any problems. I am and I don't need any help. I am that I am and time isn't, and that's it. I am not in competition with time. That's called declarations. And we're making this shift. It's all important right now, because when we're petitioning from time. We're asking time to help us, actually. We call it God, we call it Jesus, we call it whatever we want to call it. When we petition, we're asking time, by whatever name we want to disguise this as, for help. We're asking time for help. And the very basis of time is destabilization. Everything that you see that seems to be stable is only there to be destabilized, to give evidence of destabilization. Time is trying to get us ready for the ultimate destabilization, which is for spirit to become prime creator, which should result in total annihilation, which is symbolized by mind by complete total mental chaos. And so mind is trying to get us ready, time is trying to get us ready for this total destabilization. Mind, using time, is trying to get us ready for this total destabilization. So, sure, we see things as somewhat stable, and that's the setup. And then the destabilization comes, and time says, you need to learn from this. There's like all these valuable lessons in time. That's what time says, full of lessons. What kind of lessons? Destabilization. That's it. That's the only lessons that time have to give you, is destabilization. The overlay of time is not a lesson of time. Again, we don't need time at all. We don't need time. I am what I am, and I don't need time. I am as God created me, perfect and free. I don't have any past. I don't need any past whatsoever. I don't need time. I don't need the lessons of time. The lessons of time are not mine. They're nothing. Time isn't. The lessons of time have no relevance whatsoever. So, all these videos are moving towards this declaration, this right use of mind and time, which is to declare we don't need time. So, we have this very big show because we're heading towards destabilization, major destabilization. There's always destabilization taking place in time. That's what it is for. That's what time is for. Okay, so let's not kid ourselves, all this rhetoric about, oh, time, time is aligning with what we are. Listen, we don't need anything to align with what we are. We don't need any alignment to be what we are. We don't need time to align with something to be what we are. Reality doesn't require any alignment. Reality is not aligned with anything. Reality is what it is. I am what I am. I am what I am. I don't need any of the alignments of time. See, I am what I am. I don't need the alignments of time to be what I am. I am what I am. Another declaration. I am what I am. I don't need any alignments to be what I am. So time is nothing but alignments. Okay, the universe is nothing but alignments, constantly changing kaleidoscopic alignments. And time tells us that we need to get the right alignments to be happy. Nonsense. We were not created to be at the mercy of alignments. All these alignments take the planets, the universal cosmic forces, all these alignments, and if the alignments are right, we feel opportunity. If they're not right, we feel problems. Also, that's utter nonsense. That's a dream of time. That's a dream of a past. That's saying prior to what we are, there was this. Because keep this in mind, how can we learn to get used to total annihilation except in a dream? Is there any annihilation in reality? So if spirit wants to be prime creator, that means it has to change reality, which means reality being one indivisible whole would have to be annihilated. So Spirit says, if I want to be prime creator, I've got to get used to annihilation. I have to somehow be able to abide in annihilation. Now Spirit says, well, how can I learn to do that? Because there's no annihilation in reality whatsoever. So where can Spirit go to learn how to abide in annihilation? Only in its own imagination, only in a dream, only in a hypothetical what-if scenario. That's it. There's no learning ground in reality to learn how to survive, how to abide in annihilation, because nothing can be annihilated. Reality cannot be annihilated. Okay, everything simply is what it is. So, of course, time is just a dream. Time is simply a dream where we're trying to teach ourselves lessons that we don't need. It can never be learned. So that's all it is. So we don't need time for anything. We don't need time for anything. However, because of the continuity issue, we decide to use time as that which we overlay with perfect non-judgment and perfect realizing I don't need this at all. See, this I don't need. That's an intermediate step. With continuity, we can look and say, ah, this tree, I don't need this tree at all. This alignment, we call it tree. And this destabilization lesson, we call it tree. I don't need that tree at all to be what I am. I still am. I am what I am without any dream of that tree, you see. So you use the stuff, everything we've used for try to teach ourselves lessons of destabilization, gradual loss, but we'd say, let's get even clearer, destabilization. All right, that's even better way to talk about it. Destabilization. We don't need any of those lessons. We don't need any of them. Because I am perfectly free as God created me of any past. I don't need any past. God did not create us to need any past. We are alignment free, for I am as God created me. You can say that to include everyone. We are alignment free, for I am as God created me. We could use it for we are as God created us. It doesn't rhyme, but you can use that too. We are alignment free, for we are as God created us. Or you can say, we are alignment free, for we are God created divinity. There you go. We are alignment free, for we are God-created divinity. God did not create anything that needed some sort of alignment of the past to be what it is now. Now doesn't need any alignment of the past. The alignment of past doesn't lead up to now. It's not the foundation upon which now is built upon. Reality is not built upon a foundation of the past, of past alignments that gradually aligned properly and got reality to snap into place. That is utter, that's simply a dream. Total nonsense dream. So I am and time isn't. So when we make these declarations, it puts us on an entire different footing, you see, than petitioning. Petitioning is saying, God, my alignments aren't working very good. Can you give me better alignments? That's what it is. We're saying, please, please, God, these my alignments are terrible right now. Oh my gosh, I need better alignments. Now, as long as we make declarations that we don't need any alignments at all, I'm alignment free, for I am as God created me, perfect divinity, then we're still accustomed to alignments, and maybe it'll seem like the alignments of the world seem to get better and better and better for us, but don't buy into that. Keep continue with your declarations, because what we really want is to get to that I am realization. I am just as I was created. I've always been just as I was created and always will be. I don't have any past whatsoever. Reality doesn't have any past. Everything that is has always been, and everything that's added is one with what is always is. And it's not felt as some kind of past that was building up to this. No, it's not like that. So everything that we see, these are just forms of instability, actually. They're just forms of instability. This flower, it's drooping, the petals are falling, you see that? Instability. Look at this. You see? That's instability. That is instability. This here is just a form of instability. You say, oh, it's so beautiful. It's just a, no, it's a form of instability. It's a form of instability. And we're trying to gold mine. We're gold diggers digging for gold in the past. And I said, okay, I need to get this and this and this and this and this. If I add it all up, then I can, it'll add up to a self that I want. Nonsense. That's not the way. I am and time isn't. So, what we're talking about is going from petitioning to declarations right now, because the instability in the world is about to hit the final act, as it were, at least of this cycle. And time is going to put on a grandiose show of instability here in this world. That's its job. That's what it does. That's what it is. It's instability. Trying to teach us how to become prime creator, getting us ready, getting us accustomed to ultimately total instability, which would how we symbolize annihilation. So we need to go from petitioning to declarations. That's the whole point of this. Now, if you were to come, be walking down the road somewhere and go into a restaurant and there happens to be someone, one of the great teachers, let's say, whoever you want to say it is, and you go up to him and say, hey, oh gosh, I'm so glad to see you. I got so many troubles. Can you help me out? I mean, can you help people out? This is so terrible. And what do we need to do? Do we need to, you know, and your petitioning, teacher would just say, we'll just give you a declaration. Teacher would say, use this declaration. All right, use this one. And would be able to get you to actually start doing it. That's the hard part. Because you say, well, okay, but just first, can you grant my petition? And no, but granting petitions means giving you alignments. What you are is not the basis of any alignments whatsoever. I am alignment free, for I am as God created me. I say that. I am alignment free, for I am exactly as God created me. Flawless oneness with reality. I am as God created me, flawless oneness with reality. What I am alignment free. I am and time isn't. Okay. So what we are needs no alignments whatsoever. Doesn't need anything to align with us. We don't need time to align from us. Say, I don't need time to align with me, for I am flawless God created divinity. I don't need alignment. I don't need anything to align with me. So this is the ultimate. This is what we're trying to get to, is that which doesn't, is not needy for an alignment, to be for something to align with it. That's neediness. We don't have any needs. That's problem. We don't have any problems. Say, I am problem free, for I am as God created me. See, I don't have any needs. I don't need any help. My spirit does not need any help from time. You know, time is just alignments. We don't need any help from any alignments to be what we are. So this level of teaching is getting us close to what we need to get to. We're segueing into declarations, which is where we exactly where we have to be right now. Exactly where we have to be. And so you can, you know, chug along and say, okay, and just do it. You know, I just say, okay, this is where we're at. Now, like someone like a great teacher would inspire you, like you'd get it and you'd say, okay, this is what I need to do. This is what I'm going to do. I recall like Sri Nisargadatta talking about his guru, and his guru just told him to say this, or to, you know, have this mantra attitude or something, and just trust in me. This is what you need to do. And he just did it. People asked him, how did you get enlightened? He said, I just did what my teacher told me to do because I trusted him entirely. Well, that's a great teacher. That is a great teacher. If you're able to trust a great teacher just entirely and just do what they say, boom, you're going to get free of delusion, get free of your support, your belief that you're dependent on some sort of alignment. All right? So that's why I always say we need great teachers. It's simply that they get us to exercise, to do declarations, to actually do it and believe it. This is what we need to do. This is what we need to do. So We certainly need that, but that's no excuse for us not to get with it right now. But I know it's not the simple, easiest thing in the world, really, because we think, let's do both. Let's do petitions and declarations. No, because each one cancels the other out. See, declarations say, I am and time isn't. I am alignment free. I've always been one with divinity. See, I am alignment free. I've always been one with divinity. We don't need time at all. Again, time is actually trying to teach ourselves how to grow accustomed and ultimately be happy with a total annihilation as the foundation of a new reality. We don't need that. We never needed that. We don't need to become prime creator. That was just a whim on our part. We don't need to have a whim satisfied, and we can never satisfy it. And all we do is put ourselves through this nightmare, this death march of instability, which is time, which is existence. We don't need any alignments. All this talk about alignments is nonsense. What I am is alignment free. So this is what is crucial. If we can feel this, what I am is alignment free. When we can experience that which is alignment free, that is what we are. And that which is based on all these alignments has nothing to do with us. It's an imagined past. It is an imagined past. It's absolutely zero to do with what we are. Never will have the slightest relevance to what we are. Never. But because of continuity, we can overlay it and use it to see, this has no relevance to what I am whatsoever. It doesn't affect what I am in the slightest bit. My freedom from any need for alignments is perfect. Remains perfect no matter what I see. So, for the sake of continuity, we don't just throw it all away, but we give a new purpose, a new use to everything that we see. We absolutely can do that. I am alignment free. I give a new purpose to everything I see. What I am is alignment free. I give a new purpose to everything that I see. So real teaching actually right now is this new style of kirtan, call and response, is someone makes a declaration, the kirtan, the one that makes the declaration, and then everybody else repeats it. That is the right type of teaching right now, as a matter of fact. The time for struggling with trying to align concepts is over. It's over. Because the destabilization is coming. And of course, time always calls it new alignments are coming. All these wonderful new alignments are coming. But first, time says, we must tear down all the old alignments. In other words, destabilization. But time is lying, of course, because its real purpose is not for new alignments to come in. Its real purpose is for destabilization to take place. But how can it do that unless it says, hey, new alignments are coming in that are wonderful and better, and then that hooks us into this lesson of destabilization that mind is trying to teach us, you see? Mind through use of time. So, of course, mind will say, hey, folks, there's this great new cosmic alignments are coming, and you unbelievable golden age, and everybody will learn to cooperate and be one with each other, and blah, 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 and all these new alignments. But in order for this to happen, okay, there's the but, all this old stuff must be swept away. But this lesson of relinquishing all the old alignments is so good for you. It's so wonderful for you. You won't regret it. It's so great. That's always the marketing strategy of mind using time. That's the marketing strategy. It's absolute nonsense. What we are is alignment free. We don't need any alignments to be what we are. We don't need to learn any lessons to be what we are. What we are, I am lesson free, for I am as God created me. All right? I am lesson free, for I am as God created me. I don't need any lessons. What we are doesn't need any lessons whatsoever. For the sake of continuity, we give ourselves one lesson that doesn't require any other lessons, which is just to realize that none of this affects what we are. Okay. So, the right kind of teaching now is this modern kirtan. Kirtan comes from, it was used in India and in Bengal a lot. And it's, they said like a name of divinity, and then people would repeat it. Okay, that's really the highest kind of teaching, actually. When you have a guru doing that kind of teaching, that's the highest teaching. because you're making declarations. That's powerful stuff. And that is for this day and age, that's what needs to happen. That's what needs to happen. But of course, we need to have it modified for our times and for our culture, etc. And we cannot try to use the forms of 100 years ago in Bengal right now. That's too much, way too much. We would think that too many adjustments need to be made. And the whole idea is that we're trying to say we don't need any adjustments at all. So we need to use the vernacular of the time. So I am less than free, for I am as God created me. See? That's a perfect one. So people, I can say, I am less than free, for I am exactly as God created me. And then people would say, same thing, repeat it. I am less than free, for I am exactly as God created me. So the idea is that it's not so easy for people to make these declarations because they're waiting for alignments. You say, wait, I'm not quite aligned with that yet. It's like the great guru Anandamayi said, if you wait until there aren't any waves in the ocean to jump into the ocean, you're never going to jump into the ocean, right? So all this stuff about alignment is nonsense. Don't wait. You're not waiting for some alignment to take place in order to do this. So the guru is the one who knows no alignments are necessary and just says, hey, say it. You know, I am alignment free, for I'm exactly as God created me. I'm alignment free, for I am created divinely. And you just say it. So the guru has no concerns, worries about alignments whatsoever. No concern. And so somehow that gets into people and they say, hey, I can just say this right now. I'll just say it right now. And they get into declarations. And then they start feeling, wow, you know what? This is it. This is it. This is it. This is simply stating the truth, stating the facts. All I need to do to wake up is simply state the truth of what I am. Of what I am, and renounce this imaginary past. And any lessons the imaginary past can possibly think to teach me, except the one lesson that I give it. Not that it gives me, I give it the lesson of continuity, of reflecting back to me that I am problem free, that I am alignment free. I am alignment free. You see, when you have the vision of bliss, oneness, there's no alignments at all in the world. There's only this bliss. Everything is just reflecting this oneness, this seamlessness. No alignments at all. So this is the program of the times. This is the program of the times, and I've been working on this for a long time, since 1997 actually, struggling to try and get us going on this track, because this is what is necessary. And some of you probably will start to recognize this and say, wow, yeah, destabilization. If I'm caught up in alignments, if I think that what I am is dependent upon alignments, and suddenly everything gets destabilized, what's going to happen to all my alignments? What's going to happen to my self-image? It's going to be in chaos. My mind's going to be swirling around in circles. Swirling around in circles, and I'll be extraordinarily confused, and then frightened, and then feeling I'm being attacked, and then a feeling of needing to fight against the attackers, etc. And then you're really lost into chaos, and all because this hook of somehow I need to learn the lessons of time is hooking you into that utter nonsense. So I certainly pray, let us pray that a great guru comes, and let us not expect anything from them except this call and response type of thing. Let us not place any other demands upon them whatsoever. And then we won't be disappointed, and we'll be right on point. We'll realize, ah, okay, this is what it is. Because we need to practice. We don't need to say, ah, guru, you're so wonderful. No, we need to practice. No time for maudlin sentiment or anything like that. We need to say, hey, I am, and time isn't. I am free. I need no alignments in order to be. I am perfectly free. I need no alignments in order to be. I am, and time isn't. We need to practice it. because if we don't, we're still dependent on alignments. And when everything, all the alignments change, which they are going to change, all our reference points change. If we're dependent on alignments, we will feel as if we're being disintegrating, really. Our self-concept will be disintegrating. So we cannot rely on a self-concept at this time anymore. No way. We never really could at all. But certainly at this time, we cannot rely upon self-concepts. Is any flower going to give up its petals now? They don't want to come out. There you go. Let me see if I can extricate this. Okay, so this is like our self-concept. I'll do a little demonstration here. If I can. And what we're going to do is we're going to... Let me knock down the... So you can see the petals there. Okay. And this is our self-concept, all right? And this is what happens when our self-concept, when the world starts changing all its alignments. Ow! I got the thorn there. There you go. And that's all we're left with, okay? That is all we are left with right there. Right? If we depend on self-concept, which is based on alignments, we don't want to do that. Don't want to do that. We want to make our declaration. So we end up with all these petals. And petals, our self-concept was really... Hold on one second here. Our self-concept was really just made up of petals, you see. That's it. And the petals can be realigned indefinitely, right? You get a new alignment of petals, and there you go. And a new one, and a new one, and a new one, and on and on and on. It's just, that is it. But what we are is not made up of parts, is not made up of alignments, has never been and never will be, is not dependent on the slightest bit, on any alignments whatsoever. Take a breath here. Well, take a breath. Take a breath. Take a breath. So, previously I didn't quite understand the importance of this, but now I do. Another Maya always said that the use of God's name is the highest and most effective teaching of all, and I didn't understand that. I said, what are you talking about? But now I understand if we can translate that into our context here. Now I see exactly, in other words, saying declarations of truth is the highest teaching, the most effective teaching, and the quickest, most powerful of all. For sure, that is a fact. For sure, it's a fact. Everything else is oh my gosh, it's a slow boat. So we're slow boating. We can't be slow boaters anymore, can we? We cannot be slow boaters. Really, because of destabilization. There's a certain time when a flower, you know, it gets destabilized. Here it goes again. Here it goes again. At a certain time, the petals start dropping, right? Once they dry up enough, oh, there's a whole bunch of petals down here too. Oh my gosh, it's been dropping a lot. And at that time, when the petals start dropping, that's when the destabilization occurs. So we have all these petals, you see here. And they just drop, 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 drop. And we shake them up, and you see this plate of petals. I'm going to change this here a little bit. All right, there's the plate of petals. So I'm tying it just like we pick up some petals like this, and then we drop the petals. So when we pick up the petals, we say, ah, I have a body. Look at this body. Isn't that nice? And then we go, oh, look at that. See, destabilization. We drop the petals. We pick them up again. Pick them up again. We say, now we have another body here. And then, you know, down they go again. Same thing with world. Same thing with civilizations. All destabilization. We have real pretty. We say, oh, look at this pretty body we have. And we get identified with it. Look at this pretty body. Oh, it's all this wonderful, beautiful yellow petals. So beautiful, right? So beautiful. And then we get attached to it, and then boom, you know, destabilization. Why? We say, why, God, why are you doing that to us? God's not doing it to us. We're doing it to ourselves. God's not doing any of this to us. We're doing it so we can learn to how to be totally accepting and abiding in total chaos and ultimately total annihilation, as if that were possible. As if that were possible, so we could then become prime creator, because we know that the effect of picking the idea of wanting to be prime creator, the effect of that is total annihilation, at least. And since we can't be annihilated, that experience, that effect, that can only appear symbolically, which is in the form of total mental chaos. And so time tells us that we have to learn how to get used to that, and we cannot. So that's why we keep, you know, attaching ourselves to this temporary alignments we call beauty here. All these alignments, oh, look at the trees, look at the bushes, look at the flowers, look at the people, look at everything, so wonderful. And then, poof, falls apart like a flower losing its petals. And we say, oh my God, what happened, what happened, what happened? I feel so disoriented, so chaotic, I feel so misaligned. And then time says, yeah. Time's watching. Okay, how, yeah, can you get used to that now? Can you get used to it? How do you feel about that? How do you feel? You know, I feel terrible. Time says, well, you'll get used to it in time. In time, you'll get used to it. No, you won't. No, you won't. You'll always hate it. You'll always hate it. So our only remedy is to give up the idea of wanting to be prime creator. That's the only remedy we have. For the sake of continuity, we use it in a hypothetical way, saying, well, what if I didn't want to be prime creator? And then that keeps the what if nature of dreaming still present, and we can then see everything. Says, oh, what if I didn't want to be prime creator? Well, I wouldn't have any sense of needing alignments whatsoever. I wouldn't need to leave. I wouldn't need to learn any lessons whatsoever from time. So I'm lesson free. I am as God created me. So everything you see, oh my gosh, it's not teaching me anything, and it's not giving me any lesson at all. This whole dance of destabilization is not giving me any lesson at all. Then I'm just shining in my original nature, which has no past. So, ultimately, my goal has always been to hopefully some really heavyweight teacher will come into the world and give this call and response teaching of affirmations, of declarations. That's where it's at. And then we can just accept that that's it. We don't need anything more than that. We don't need anything more than that. Of course, people, time, those who believe they need to learn the lessons of time will petition, say, oh, please help us, please. Oh, we need to learn how to flow with the adjustments and the alignments, and you need to help us get ready with the new alignments. Oh, no. Declarations only. And we need to support that. We need to accept it and support it and say, yeah, get with that. And say, this is what I know is right to do. So I've gotten myself into that clarity at this point. And there's no question that some of you are also seeing it. It's like light at the end of the tunnel. You look at the end of the tunnel and say, I see some light there. Now I see some light at the end of the tunnel. And that's what's necessary. So I've come around. I've done a U-turn on this whole thing, because I used to not understand it, because I was still working on the context of the whole thing, which is a precursor to it. Okay, there's nothing wrong with that. But at some point, you then put two and two together, and you say, oh, gosh, now I see petitions to be helped are not it. That's to say that I need help is to claim that I'm different than how God created me, which just exacerbates the whole problem. Now you say, well, what about the call and response that helps? It helps us remember that we don't need help. Okay, that's what it is. I don't need help, for I am free. I am exactly the way that God created me. I don't need alignments. I am free, for I am exactly the way that God created me. So really, you know, what I'm looking for in the world is that perfect, the one who's perfectly perfect, adept at declarations like that. Can't find it so far, not being able to find it. All this nonsense, other stuff is, it's not nonsense. That's too strong a word to use. It's too slow. It's slow boating. We can't use that anymore. We cannot use that anymore. It's kind of preparatory. But preparation is useless if you then don't take the next step for what it was preparing for. If you stop short of what it's preparing for, then it ends up to being insufficient and just a trap. It's like saying, well, I'm doing all the spiritual stuff as a way to pass some time until the destabilization comes so I can learn that lesson that I need. I am lesson free, for I'm exactly as God created me. I am and time isn't. You see, that is the kind of stuff that we need. And I know it can be done on a superlative level, actually, where we really get it, where we really get it. It is very possible now for this to take place. So we'll take another little break now. We don't have to forge ahead constantly. We'll take a little break. Now, time is very tricky. The mind has to be very tricky in trying to present this idea to us because we don't really want it. We want something else better, but time, this is the only thing that time can do. Mind can only do this. That's it. It has to try to get us aligned with total mental chaos. And we don't want, we cannot be aligned with it. We have limits to what we can accept, and spirit cannot accept, the depiction of total disempowerment and total lack of freedom and total dissolution. It's not possible, because that which is viewing all this is perfectly intact, 100%, and so that cancels out the very thing it's viewing, and there's just total conflict there, you see, and that cannot be maintained at all. Each one gives a lie to the other, and so there's no place to abide there. There's no gap to abide in, actually. When you become aware of total mental chaos, there's no gap to abide in. There's nothing to abide in either. You say, this is not acceptable. It's not acceptable. So we cannot learn to abide in it. So all these lessons of time are useless. They're useless, completely useless to everyone. And yet, from the standpoint of theory, it's not enough. It's never enough. Theory is never enough. Practice is necessary. Declarations are necessary. So again, we're going from petitions to declarations now. Petition is to ask for help, saying, help in the form of help. The alignments are changing. It's like what we basically are saying, God, all the alignments are changing. I'm feeling like what I am is in danger. What I am is changing. It's unstable. I feel this instability. Please help with the alignments. Can you make better alignments for me? If God were to do that, God would be saying that you're not as you were created. So what God says, look, instead of petitioning, make declarations. Make declarations. So the real teachers come here to help us make declarations, and they're very adamant, and they're super, super skillful at that. So, again, I'm able to make declarations. I'm not super, super skillful, but at least I'm aligned in that direction, in the appropriate direction. Well, there's some those in the world who come here, they say that they're very helpful and great teachers, but they're not able to make the declarations. They're not adamant. They're not super adept at it at all. So that's bogus. That's not it. Any true great teacher would be able to absolutely dwell in simple declarations at that level easily, and not even have any need to step down into anything conceptual at all, really. You could feel that. You would feel like they don't have the slightest need to step down into conceptual alignments at all. Now, they may talk chit-chat or something, you know, because you're tired of working on declarations. You might need a breather. But you can feel from them there's absolutely no need for that. And then you know. Then you've got something. You've got the real teacher right there. Now some just wait. They say, okay, the teacher is doing this mumbo jumbo of declarations, and they're waiting for the teacher then to help them with their alignments. That's not it. That's not it either. And there's no need to be helped with any alignments from that standpoint. Again, alignments will smooth out. Everything will naturally smooth out. Once, when you start making declarations, it'll just naturally, automatically smooth out. That's what they tell us. So don't even worry about it. I am what I am is alignment free. I am exactly as God created me. I am one with divinity. I have no past. I am free. I am exactly as God created me. Past alignments are unnecessary for me. What I am is exactly what God created me to be. What I am is exactly what God created me to be. There is no such thing as any alignment that is necessary for me. No such thing as any alignment that is necessary for me. So several things we're dealing with here. One is at least keeping our minds open to really super help, and to not expect anything other than declarations, and not demand it, and not pout about it, and not try to scheme for something different, or think like, hey, maybe I can, you know, spin this off in some way. No, just stay with the declarations. Now, of course, time will say, oh, that's too simplistic. How are you going to learn the lessons of time from that? You got to also learn the lessons of time. Time will say, well, that's good if it helps you learn the lessons of time. Again, there are no lessons of time for me to learn. I am lesson free, for I am only what God created me to be. See, I don't have any past. How else can we pretend to be prime creators? If we say, yeah, sure, God, you created all reality, but I created what came before reality. I created the past of reality, you see. Now we're just saying, I created God. I created reality out of my alignments of the past. So, my experience is it's not so simple to just declarations. People have resistance because mind tells them, no, that's too simplistic. No. I am and time isn't. See, oh no, that's too simplistic. What do you mean? No, it's not too simplistic. It's perfect. See, time misrepresents perfection as some kind of simplicity. There's no concept of simplicity in reality. It just, what is, is. There's no option to be other than what it is, so how can you even bring the conceptual level into reality? You cannot. So, it's not simple, it's not complex, it just is what it is. But mind says, oh, that's too simple. How can you? See, I can't teach you the lessons you need to learn. I don't need to learn any lessons. I'm lesson free. So I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. So the great teachers are able to get this call and response going, this declarations, get these declarations going. And that's all that people do. That's all there is. There's no hierarchy. There's no all this. Everybody wants to be special and how, you know, align with the guru. There's no alignment. There's no alignment. We're alignment free. The guru just now telling you, you know, you are alignment free. I am alignment free. I'm as God created me. There are no lessons that I need to learn. So we just have to forget about, you know, status, position, how are we aligning, all this kind of stuff, and just do the declarations. Just do the declarations. And yet people think, well, how do I align with the guru so that I'm, so I am what I, so I become what I am. How can I become what I need to become? There's no becoming. There's no becoming in reality. I am process free. I was created as divinity. I am process free. What I am is totally process free, totally alignment free, totally time free. With no necessity to be anything other than that. It's just a crazy whim we had of wanting to be prime creator gave rise to this, all this nonsense. All this nonsense of trying to teach ourselves a lesson that can never be learned. In a hypothetical, imaginary place called the past, called time. Past with this hypothetical nonsense of destabilization. Don't try to stabilize time. Time is destabilization. How can you stabilize a dream? How can you stabilize imagination of destabilization? It is what it is. Don't try to destabilize it. Choose a different idea instead, where all this dance of time doesn't give any sense of destabilization in you whatsoever, because you don't need to learn any lessons from it. Don't need to learn any lessons from it at all. What I am is lesson free. Time isn't necessary for me. What I am is lesson free. And time is absolutely unnecessary for me. Say that one. What I am is lesson free. Time is entirely unnecessary for me. What I am is lesson free. Time is unnecessary for me. I am lesson free. Time is unnecessary for me. Various slight variations one can use. I have no lessons to learn. It doesn't matter if time burns. Right? I have no lessons to learn. It doesn't matter if time burns. I have no lessons to learn. It doesn't affect me if time burns. And time most certainly burns. It's always burning. It's always burning down. Everything is always burning down here, actually. The whole universe is like a big fire, constantly burning, and we keep imagining more fuel for this imaginary fire. We keep stoking this imaginary fire. It's really just a big imaginary fire. And we just keep pouring fuel on. We imagine, hey, here's some more fuel. How about that? Let's throw that on the fire. And we just keep this fire burning. Imaginary fuel. Fire of instability. I have no lessons to learn. Doesn't bother me. It doesn't affect me if the whole universe burns. And Anima, I said what I am. Remains exactly the way it is, no matter how the dance of the universe dances for all eternity, makes no difference to what I am. Same thing. I have no lessons to learn. It doesn't affect me if the universe burns. Let the universe burn. I have no lessons to learn. So really, the true guru knows this, that it doesn't make any difference at all what time does to what we are. It has no effect at all. None. Zero. Never has had any effect. Never will have any effect. Completely unnecessary. For the sake of continuity, we allow the forms to dance a little longer as we realize that it has no effect on us, and then we can set that dance down, quote unquote, go to the unmanifest in terms of time, unmanifest in terms of time, but not unmanifest in terms of reality. Beautiful day today. We're back in the good weather here. That's unbelievable. The weather's always being destabilized, isn't it? You get set up. California's the ultimate setup. I'll tell you that. If you live in California, you get the opportunity to get a very good sense of the setup, that the way that time works. Because here, the forms of stability, the forms of instability that are set up to attract you seem much more attractive. You have the Palo Alto, the high trees, the big trees. Palo Alto means Palo's tree, Alto's high. There's all these redwood trees. You know, you get these massive redwood trees, massive sequoias. You get the beautiful beach bunnies. You know, you get the beautiful snow-capped mountains of the Eastern Sierra. You get the beautiful Yosemite. You get all this lovely forms. You get this incredible weather where people are driving in their convertible Mercedes, and they're all, you know, all looking so handsome and beautiful and healthy, and their teeth are perfect, and their tan is perfect, and they seem to be so at ease, you know, and they're cruising through these beautiful neighborhoods and streets and gorgeous scenery everywhere, and the day is like sparkling, and you say, ah, This is, I get used to this. and then the problems come, you know, and it destabilizes, and we go, what the heck happened? What is going on? I mean, I get so upset when the weather isn't perfect, really. And it's just like, I feel like I've been robbed of my identity, because I identify with the weather so much. Because here in California, it's so easy to identify with the environment, with the weather, you know, with our environment, so easy. That's the problem here. Big problem. So when the weather changes, I get depressed. I feel like destabilized. I feel like my identity is destabilized. That's terrible. Absolutely terrible. Because the temptations to identify are greater here. They're much greater. One of the most tempting places in the world to misidentify with time is right here in California. Bay Area, Southern Cal, the whole all of California. But it's like the liquid sunshine, you know, it's just, everything seems just like ideal, so ideal. And we get hooked into that sense of ideal, and then things start destabilizing, as they have here. The whole state has been so terribly destabilized, and it traumatizes us terribly. I've been terribly traumatized here in California. What a nightmare. Because you think, wow, everything's perfect, and wait a minute, we've got these huge problems here. And suddenly the creeping problems creep in. All these problems creep in. All these problems sneak into the system. Now we're on the verge of bankruptcy. Cities are going bankrupt, cutting back on everything. We don't have money, raising taxes, new regulations, constant new laws. Everybody's like all obsessed with control. You say, oh my gosh, you know, and we used to have the really terrible smog, and then we finally, you know, cleaned that up, but we got more and more problems keep mounting. The terrible wildfires come, you know, they're perfect days, and then suddenly wildfires start, and everyone's terrified. You, on and on and on and on and on. I remember the 60s, oh, it seemed so incredible here. We thought, ah, you know, then the new age is here now, and then those knuckleheads down in Southern California, the Manson family and stuff, just absolutely ruined the vibe for everybody. They just, Everything changed just from this effort to destabilize. See, time destabilized. Time has all sorts of ways to destabilize. Oh, you wouldn't believe all the ways time has to destabilize. It's endless, as an endless grab bag. Every time we think we're getting something stable, some horrible scenario crops up and just, you know, lose it all. Because, I mean, Summer of Love, 67. And everybody's dancing in Golden Gate Park. And we think that paradise is here. And we go down to Big Sur. And it's just like, wow. We were just all like, wow, California dreaming. My mamas and papas are saying, California dreaming, you know. It's just incredible. And then all the problems, all the just like this doggone video just destabilized for a second. Okay, it's
usually when things are its very best that suddenly the destabilization smacks you, as it were. That happened to me again down in the Palm Springs area. And it was like the most perfect day you could ever imagine. I was like in the most perfect place imaginable. It was just like heaven. And people, we were sitting there. We couldn't even move. We said, why do we need to move? Everything's perfect.
And then we finally had to go home. We were driving down a road. I've said this before. And suddenly there's this scene up here and everyone stopped. And there was this horrible accident. And I ended up having to deal with everything, calling 911, trying to calm people down. And I took charge of the whole accident scene, you know, because people are so stunned. They didn't know what to do. But it caused me this incredible destabilization. It was just horrible. So we went from like the most idyllic, stable situation possible to this just horrible destabilization. I eventually went back up to the place, a beautiful place, and we just hung out there and calmed down. That just shows you, you know. I'm always wary when things seem to be going really well in this world. It's a setup. I know the gurus think, oh, enjoy life, be happy. That's nonsense. Those aren't the real gurus. Because the good times are a setup for the bad times in time. And people should know that fact. That is just a fact. Whatever is good in time is just a setup to entrap your attention so then you can be pounded with destabilization so you can learn the lessons of time that time is trying to teach you. That's all that it is. But the realization of what I am lesson free, that's different. That is not a lesson of time. That is not a stabilization within time. Where maybe we still appear in time, we're not of it. What I am is not of time at all. So that is not a setup. That's the one thing that is not a setup. But we're very jittery about anything that's good. We've learned if you're in this world long enough, you realize anything that seems to be good is sugarcoating something that bad that's coming along. So don't be seeking something good in the world. Forget about it. Just make declarations. And you know, no good deed goes unpunished. No good thing. You try to make something beautiful here, it attracts trouble. I just found that out, you know. It attracts trouble. That's all. It attracts destabilization. Because that's what time is all about. And time saying, ah, look at this. A nice situation. Perfect for me to destabilize it. The parasites of time come in and start destabilizing it. So, it's tough for any situation in this world to function well. For instance, the guru in declarations making, call and response declarations, they're able to somehow keep that going, keep it going, keep it going. Because it's really not it's trying to stabilize anything in time. Is trying to realize that we don't need any time-based alignments whatsoever. We are alignment-free. We are exactly, I am exactly as God created me. I'm alignment-free. I don't need any, I'm not dependent on any alignments whatsoever. But still, anything you try to set up as stable in this world is going to attract those who want to tear it down into instability, to destabilize it. Absolutely. That's because that's what time does. That is what time does. America is experiencing that right now. We tried to build up the super stable country, the perfect model of stability and whatnot. What's happening? It's being torn. Its stability is being torn to pieces. It's being destabilized. And that's like going to continue. And the world itself may go likely to go into an extraordinarily destabilizing scenario coming up. We've already been through in the last 100 years. Look what happened. I mean, basically it's been 100 years since World War I started, right? 1914, I think it was. It's been 100 years, right? And in that time, look at all the destabilization that has taken place on this planet. World War I, World War II. I put a list of all the wars of the last 100 years in one of my videos. And it's so many, you can't even believe it. You just think, is this true? Is this being made up? No, it's not being made up. It's not being made up at all. And yet we have this time now where we've kind of think that we've reached this stabilization in the world. Everything's built up. What is that? Wonderfully. And, I don't know what that is. So, again, time will come in and destabilize it for us. It already did. Like 9/11 was a supremely destabilizing moment, was it not? And yet, there are more destabilizations to come, without a doubt. And you don't even have to know what they are to know that's what time does. So we shouldn't be surprised at all by anything that happens. It's just business as usual for time. And we, just when we think we've changed time's mind, its purpose, that's when it hits us. We cannot change the time's purpose. That's time. We can overlay it, though. That's different. That's different. We can choose a new purpose. We can give a new purpose to the world. It doesn't have to reflect time, but we can't just the time itself. We cannot do that. Time is what it is. So as soon as we think we've got time working the way we want it to work, that's when we're going to get destabilized. And we know the financial instability in the world. We know the social instability. We know all the instabilities that are at play in the world. And yet they have not crystallized into some overt situation that really causes the issues. But you can bet that time will do that. You can bet on it. So don't bet on time to help you out, to save you at all. Yet so many do that. What they do is they use the destabilization that's taking place to try and gain some new stability, more control, that they're on top. They have the stability now and others are suffering the instability. That's just getting nowhere. That is just getting absolutely nowhere. That's not the answer. It's like when you get your garden planted and everything's perfect. What happens? That's when the gophers show up. Right? That's when the trouble shows up. That's why it always says, just when people are saying peace, 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 that's when you need to, you know, flee. Flee for the mountains, as it were. So in these call and response declarations, they often go on for quite some time, as a matter of fact. Generally speaking, It's an all-day affair, and oftentimes an all-weekend situation. And it can go on for a week or something. It's not just like 5 minutes. Forget it. 5 minutes, forget it. You know, that's a start. But let's not kid ourselves. You need to do it, take a break, and then go back and try it again. Take a break and go back and try it again. It's like really, it's like a lifeline. You need to keep re-gripping this lifeline, this life preserver. In a stormy sea, and get a better grip on it. Get a better grip. Get a better grip. Get a better grip. So generally, they're organized around a program of this that you spend a lot of time at it, very intense, and then you take a break, and then very intense, and take a break, and very intense. So intensives are helpful. It's the time element. You need to have endurance. You need to keep doing this. That's why these videos, I keep saying, I keep doing them, you know, hour, 2 hours, to get you prepared. You have to be prepared. These 2 minute, 5 minute blurbs, you think, oh, okay, I got it, yeah. There is no me, I get it, that's it, I get it. Now, that doesn't get you prepared for what you need to do is declaration, 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 increase it, increase it, get the whole, your whole vibe is now declaration instead of petitioning. There's a huge transfer over. It's like crossing a bridge, a big bridge, and it's not with one step. You don't cross a bridge with one step. I know we all think that we're so smart we can do it, but don't outsmart yourself. Don't forego practicing, religious practicing, vigorous practicing, which in today's world it's tough. I mean, I don't even practice, except these videos is my practice, because we feel, oh my gosh, we don't want to be completely out of sync with society, right? Completely out of sync with society. And again, it's not an emotionalism. It's not an emotionalism. There's a soberness to it. There's a soberness to it. There's an adamancy, a sober adamancy to it. I am and time isn't. I am and time isn't. Bliss is not some emotional condition. It's a feeling of total stability. It's a feeling of alignment freeness. Bliss is not dependent on any alignment whatsoever. So that which is not dependent on any alignment doesn't need to be making these emotional alignments. I'm emotional. No, quiet, still, intense stillness, effortless intense stillness of just no alignments involved. No alignments involved, bliss is all. No alignments for me, bliss sets me free. No alignments for me, bliss sets me free. So there's another one. We can say, no alignments for me. Everyone says, no alignments for me. And then, bliss sets me free. Bliss sets me free. No alignments for me, bliss sets me free. No alignments for me. Bliss sets me free. Bliss is alignment free. No more troubles for me. Bliss is alignment free. No more troubles for me. Bliss is alignment free. No more petitions for me. Bliss is alignment free. No more petitions for me. Bliss is alignment free. So, I'm just looking at my mind to see if it's wandering off. Not really. It's pretty much staying in the declaration mode, which is what's important. The heavyweight gurus are effortlessly in that mode. Without any, their minds don't wander off at all. Whereas those who are making the response, their minds might start off to wander and thinking about, how do I align with that person? I like that person over there. I wonder how am I going to align with that person? You know, no, but what you need to say, no, I am alignment free. Bliss is always there for me. I am alignment free. Bliss is always there for me. I am alignment free. Bliss is always there for me. And then you're not worrying about making alignments, you see. And it's been said that those who come to satsang, that there's more alignments taking place than ever. People are scheming, like, okay, how do I align with the guru? How do I align? Who's aligned with the guru? Okay, who's the top one? Maybe I can align with them, or maybe they have some friend that's aligned with them, and I can align with them. And who do I see that's attracted to me, and I can align? How do I align with them? And so they they might go up and say, okay, yes, I love you. I love you so much. I always will love you. And I'm not the self. There is no I. I'm not the self, but I'm just love. And so, and then they go back and say, okay, now how do I align with you? Is this aligning with you? Go to the guru. Guru, am I aligning with you now? Am I aligning with you now? The guru says, there's no alignments needed. I'm alignment free. Be alignment free. So it requires a very adamant presence to handle any group situation of call and response. Absolutely. Because everybody is going to be, they feel so challenged, like their petitioning is being challenged, their lessons of time are being challenged. They're being said, drop your lessons of time, you don't need them. They're saying, oh my gosh, but I need them to become what I am. Why do we need to learn how to become what we already are? Because, again, the idea of wanting to be prime creator is what's bringing all this about. And people don't see that. They don't realize that. And that's the trouble. So their minds wander off and say, wait a minute. I can't drop the lessons of time entirely. I just want to I want to add to them. I want to compliment them. This is complimentary. This whole idea, well, this is complimentary. Time will come up to you and say, hi. I'm so great you're following the teachings of so-and-so or Jesus or doing declarations. Say, so great you're doing declarations. But you know what? I've been sent to you specifically to help you out and give you something complimentary to this. It's free. It's complimentary. It's free. And it's designed to be a compliment to what you're doing. And then everything will work even better for you. That's what time will say to you. That's what time will say. It's a total delusion. It's a total lie. I don't need anything to compliment me, because I'm exactly as God. God created me perfectly free. I don't need anything complimentary to set me free. I'm exactly as God created me. So time, in his most beguiling approaches, will try to get you to believe you need to do something complimentary, that it knows. It won't say stop doing declarations. It'll just say, oh, that's okay, but look at this, what I have for you. All these alignments, I know how to align you just right. And then you get caught up in all that, and you stop doing declarations altogether, and you get lost into terrible wastage of time. Absolutely. And so this is bound to happen, that time will try to claim that it's complementary to declarations. It says, oh, I got some petitions that are complementary to your declarations. No, there's no such thing. Declarations deny the necessity of any petitions whatsoever. I don't need any help at all. How could what God created need help? When we say I need help, it means I need help to learn the lessons so I can become what I am already. What it really means is I need help to learn the lessons so I can become the prime creator, become something other than what I am. Lessons are only come about when we're trying to be something other than what we are. Learning, alignments, complementariness, all those petitions, that's only because we're trying to become something different than what God created us to be. That's it. There's no other justification, no other cause of it whatsoever. None. And there's a tendency when you're doing declarations to think that everybody else is passing you by because they're learning the lessons, they're adjusting, they're making alignments, new alignments. Oh, I'm making alignments. And you think, I'm not making any alignments. I'm going to be left behind. So yeah, you have to have some spiritual maturity to handle this. No, you're just simply not wasting your time anymore. Time claims that it's teaching everyone how to be something different than what they are. All these lessons are nothing but a waste of time. You get nowhere. It's like a rat on one of those wheels in a cage. The rat's running. You're watching the rat, and the rat says, how come you're not running on your wheel? I'm leaving you way behind. Look how far I'm traveling, and you're being left behind. I say, what are you talking about, rat? You're still right in the exact same place you've always been. You're just running on a treadmill. You're not getting anywhere. So the world, time is just on a treadmill. Here's another. Time is a treadmill. Time is a treadmill. That's all that it is. So those on the treadmill are saying, I'm really getting ready to get somewhere. No, you're just running on a treadmill. Time is a treadmill. I don't need a treadmill. I am and time isn't. 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 And that's it. So, those who are on a treadmill claiming that they're leaving you in the dust, you know, it's just delusion. It's just they're trying to learn how to become something different than what they are, which is impossible. And they want you to support their delusions by joining them and on the treadmill. See, get on your treadmill. Come on, together we can get somewhere. But you must help me. We must help one another. Together, we can get somewhere. If we just all jump on treadmills, then we're all reinforcing each other's delusions, and we're all preparing for a bigger destabilization event. And therefore, we can succeed. Of course, see, time is really telling everybody that we have to succeed to be able to abide in total mental chaos. And so these lessons are absolutely all important for everybody. And that the more people, more that participate in these lessons, the more reinforcement the lessons have for everybody. So time wants everybody to go along with these lessons of destabilization, in other words, to suffer the trauma of destabilization, so then we can all pool our learning together, as it were. And then this should add up to reinforcing one another that we can all abide in total mental chaos. So time wants everybody to participate, thinking that that's great for everybody. It's not. It only reinforces delusion. I get off the treadmill of time and realize that I am entirely divine. See, I get off the treadmill of time to realize that I am totally divine. I get off the treadmill of time to realize I've always been divine. I step off the treadmill of time and realize that I've always been divine. I get off the treadmill, I make the step off the treadmill of time, and now I realize I've always been divine. I make the step off the treadmill of time, and now I realize I've always been divine. So it also helps to have a perfect teacher or guru, because when people mock you, say, oh, we're leaving you in the dust, you can say no, because this teacher says that what I'm doing is exactly right. And so it takes away the sting of mockery. And so, and certainly you get that. Those are on the treadmills. They want to believe what they're doing is going to pay off. So they see you off the treadmill. They say, hey, you know, why are you doing that? That's nuts. You must be crazy, because treadmill's all important. The treadmill of time is all important. The lessons of time, they say, is all important, and you have to stay on it. Otherwise, you're going to be lost and forsaken and annihilated. How can you know? You're not going to get used to annihilation. You can't become prime creator if you get off the treadmill. You say, I don't need to be, because accepting what I am as God created me is perfect reality. Perfect divinity, perfect reality. Reality is all one. There's nobody that has more or less. Reality is perfectly shared with all of reality. All of the oneness is one with all of the oneness. There's no such thing as someone has more and someone has less. There's no more or less at all. So why do I need to be something more? I don't. I already have all. Eternally, endlessly all. I already have it. It's just a whim to think there's something more than that. Total whim. Take a little break. I leave behind the treadmill of time to enter in the bliss divine. I leave behind the treadmill of time to enter in to that bliss so divine. I leave behind the treadmill of time to enter in to that bliss divine. It's one or the other. We're either in bliss divine or we're on the treadmill of time. There isn't any other situation we can be in when it comes to hypotheticals. Ultimately, we set down even the bliss and realize that we never left the oneness. And I don't have any continuity issue, therefore. But again, that's beyond the scope of what we need to focus on. So I'm either experiencing the treadmill of time or bliss divine. And the treadmill of time is seen as we've seen it to be entirely bogus. I don't have any past. What I am was created to last. See, I don't have any past. What I am was created to last. I don't have any past. What I am was created to last. I don't have any past. What I am was created to last. Doesn't have any past. What I am, I don't have any past. What I am was created to last.
What I am was created to last. I don't need to have any past. I don't need to imagine any past. What I am was created to pass. I don't need to imagine any past.
So again, we're practicing declaration mode here. That's what we're going into now, practicing declaration mode. Those who do that, guaranteed to be capable of hanging out with a great teacher. So the practice is very helpful. The preparation is very helpful. And even the inner guru can come forth too. And when we relate to the inner guru, we can relate through declarations like that. The inner presence, the presence of the self, we can relate to it through declarations. Not that, since we're still in used to dreaming and hypotheticalness, we have this continuity issue, so we feel we need to somehow relate to something, that we relate to what we already are. We can relate to the self, what we are, what we really are, our true self, through these declarations, simply expressions of declaration. I am this. I am that. And time isn't. I am the self and time is nothing. I am the self and time is nothing. I am the self and the past is nowhere. I am the self and the past is nowhere. I am one with the self. I am the self, and the past is nowhere. I am the self, and time is nothing. I am the self, and the past is nothing. I am the self, and the past is nowhere. I am the self, and time is nothing. I am the self, and the past is nowhere. So, declarations that we move a little more than saying, well, I am one with the self. No, say, I am the self. Because if you say, I am one with the self, then what is this I that is one with the self? Where does that come from? No, I am the self. I am the self, and the past is nothing. I am the self, and the past is nothing. How are we doing here? Still recording. Keep our fingers crossed. I'm having the most extraordinary technical difficulties and getting blocked in so many ways. This recording this way is not the most ideal, because if I'm interrupted, I'm unable to shift to a blank slide, as it were, with no audio. I cannot do that. It's not possible to do that. I don't even have any way to mute the audio at all. So if I were to be interrupted, I could not do anything about it. That's why Ustream is better. I can go over to a slide or anything I want to, a different video or whatever, with either its own audio content or no audio. And so I'm able to deal with interruptions and then get right back to the situation. Here I cannot do that. There's no pause either. No pause on Ustream either, but I can sidestep it. I do have a video camera now with pause, a digital video camera with pause, and I might have to employ it at some point where I could just stop. But I can't use it as a webcam, so I'd have to record to the memory disk. But if somebody comes, interrupted, I can hit pause and then restart it. It's still one video. Or I can hit here, I can just stop the video, and that'll go to disk, and then I can start a new one, upload both to YouTube, and then edit them together. But really, wow, again, technical things, we think they work great, and then they destabilize on us, right? Absolutely they do. So I'm, trying to adapt here, and this, the audio and video is not perfect here, but it's good enough to get through, that's for sure. And don't be in a hurry to look for results. Don't be in a hurry to look for results. It's subtle. I can tell you for sure the capacity to make these declarations. These are all just spontaneous. I don't have some script I'm reading and telling me what the declarations need to be. They're just occurring to me spontaneously. That's a sign of progress right there. The ability to listen to this, the ability to do these, that's all a sign of progress. But we might be looking, where's the bliss? Where's the bliss? But we're really saying, how can I align with bliss? I don't need to align with bliss. I am bliss. I am the self. I am the self, and the past is nowhere. I am the self, and the past is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. Don't call time bad, or it's nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. Time is nothing. Time doesn't need to be defeated. It's nothing. It's nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. So that's a powerful one, too. I feel that we can say, I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nowhere. I am in bliss, and time is nowhere. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am in bliss, and time is nowhere. I am bliss, and the past is nothing. I am in bliss, and the past is nowhere. I am in bliss, and the past is nowhere. So again, I wish there was some capacity to prevail upon people to do this, because destabilization is coming. It's always with us, 24/7, and in time is always with us. But sometimes it gets really heavy. We don't want to wait until it gets really heavy in order to get work on this. For example, in 1997, and actually the end of 1997, it started in the summer of 97, and by I think January 1st of 1998, I was shown the whole picture of the future, the destabilization to come. And from that point, I began working intensely to say, what do I do, you know, how do I deal with this? And I became introduced to this declarations through... first, I was introduced to declarations in 1978 with A Course in Miracles, which led up then in 1998, 20 years later, 98, I was introduced to Ananda Maima, who's the great master of declarations. Truly, there's never been anyone better at it. And I began studying, saying, oh, what is this? You know, how does she do this? What's so important about this? And so that was before 2001, 9/11, of course. It was before. So I was already aware of all this stuff before the destabilization, the first part really hit hard. Before, you see, I'd already worked on it before for 2000, almost 4 years before I've been working on it, intensely working on it. So I didn't wait until after, you know, for this. I said, no, I already had momentum going. So we don't want to wait and react to what happens. We want us to be aware it's before it even comes. We want to be aware that we need to get going. We need to get out of town and get out of Dodge, as it were. So that's why I keep hoping to prevail upon everyone to... Don't wait and see. Wait a minute. Is this really going to happen? Time is always destabilizing. So it's always perfect opportunity right now to do it. Don't wait until some really very bad destabilization comes. As it inevitably will in time. Always is. World War I came. World War II came. Right? All these wars came. Vietnam War came. And many, many other wars in the last 100 years that are just unbelievable. The African World War, as it were. So many. All over the globe. Severe destabilizations. Of course, maybe we'll be sitting in our nice suburban home and everything seems so stable here. And yet the destabilizations around the globe are happening all the time. And eventually the floodwaters hit you. Eventually the floodwaters can hit even you and your suburban enclaves. And indeed we did. I mean, living here in supposedly ideal suburbia had terrible destabilization. One of the worst is the drug scourge that came into the suburbs. Absolutely horrible. Absolutely horrible. People were dying. Families were being ruined. Suicides. It was a nightmare. Absolute nightmare. We thought, our lives are so perfect here in suburbia. No, they weren't at all. It's horrible, horrible scourge. And there are many other horrible scourges that swept through the supposedly idyllic suburbia. And continue to. And of course the economic recession was a terrible scourge. It continues to be for many. Even though the recession seems to be money, the stock market's up, etc., it's because those who have are getting a lot more. So it seems like happy times are here again. But it's not, because that doesn't really trickle down. What they're doing is consolidating power. They're not really trickling it down vigorously. It's being consolidated more and more around globally. So the scourge is the middle class. The scourge of the middle class is horrible right now, actually. Lack of equity, lack of retirement. You know, who can afford the future, really? Can I afford to get old? I can't afford to get old. I cannot afford. How can I afford to get old? There's no way. So I have to accept I am bliss, and time is nothing. Right? I am bliss right now, and time is nothing. And time has never been anything. Time is always nothing. I am bliss right now, and time is always nothing. If you can't afford the future, you need to be time free. You need to be time free. Who can afford the future right now? Very few can actually afford the future. So destabilization is always sweeping through. Always sweeping through. There's no place to hide from it. You know, it's a complete delusion to think that we're in some idyllic suburban enclave, which is where I live, and somehow that we're free of scourges. Not true at all. another scourge here. I mean, we were like a small town, idyllic small town, and just everything felt insulated from the world. And then the high-tech revolution happened here, and everything utterly changed. It was horrible. It was absolutely horrible. People just flooded in here from all over the world with completely different sensibilities. Just the whole sensibilities were in just constant turmoil here. It was unbelievable. You get this so much wealth here, and then attracts all of these various types of people here to that wealth, to exploit it, to get a hold of it, to get it in their hands, etc., etc. People became very unfriendly. There's no friendliness. This town used to be very, it's very friendly, you know, kind of feeling. People smile, hi, how are you doing? It completely changed once the high-tech revolution came, and this became a better community for all the managers of all these high-tech companies. Is no friendliness here. I've not felt any friendliness here for the longest time. I can't remember last, you know, real true friendliness. And of course, the gold diggers came here in mass from all over the world, and they can appear to be friendly, but that's if they think that you're, you know, multimillionaire. But if they don't think you're multimillionaire, you don't even exist. Don't even exist, even beyond unfriendliness. You don't even exist. So there's this feeling like if you're not wealthy, you don't exist. That kind of thing. Whereas before, people did not judge you on your economic stance so much. You know, we're all just kind of middle class. We're all just, you know, folks. And that's okay. It's okay to be what we are. So that was an enormous scourge. And of course, property values went crazy. You can't afford to live here. And if you didn't already live here, people can't afford to live here. Everything changed in ways that I felt were very, very nasty. A scourge. So there's another. See, all sorts of scourges happen. Constantly destabilization. There's no more open space here. In all the lots, we used to have open space everywhere. Now everything is built up. Everything is built up. You can't let your house just be kind of humble. You have to keep up appearances of being prosperous and a top performer. You can't go out in public in just the way you want to. You got to have the appearance of being a top performer, basically, or else. I used to ignore that, but the vibe you get is like, who are you? You don't belong here. I say, I've been here my whole life. It doesn't matter. I say, you don't belong here. You're hurting our vibe. We're all top performers here, and your vibe isn't a top performer, so we don't want you here. You get that feeling of being pushed out of your own, you know, hometown, home place, your own home. You get a feeling of being edged out, pushed out, encroached upon, all this stuff. You know, intense pressure to keep up with the Joneses. Oh, so it's one scourge after the other here, actually. Frantic pace of life becomes so frantic. Everybody's looking for an edge. Everybody's trying to top you, you know, and stuff. And so this is an illusion to think that we can find happiness in time. Absolute illusion. But I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am blessed and time is nothing. These declarations are only protection we really have. So, I am blessed and time is nothing. See, we're on a treadmill of time or we're in bliss. So, we need to declare our choice. Don't ask permission from time. Don't petition time for bliss. Say, time, can you give me bliss, please? I mean, I don't want to get out of alignment with you, time, but if you can give me the right alignments, maybe I can have bliss. Don't do that. See, I am bliss, and time is nothing. So it takes courage to say that, right? It's like, whoa, time might get mad at me, you know, for saying that. It doesn't matter. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. Now we still function in time, but we realize it's nothing. I still got to look at the watch. What time is it right now? I say, this is chronological time. That's not what I'm really talking about. We still, of course, we're still aware of chronological time. It's the, we need, if we need to do something, we're aware of that. But I'm talking about purpose of time, lessons of time. Time is nothing. Destabilization. I have no need for that at all. No need to learn the lessons of time. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and time is nothing. That's a powerful.
I am, and time isn't. I am, and time isn't. I am bliss, and time is nothing. Yes. Gives one the feeling like, hey, I really am in charge of what I am. Time is not going to bully me anymore. I am bliss, and time is nothing.
So when I say this, I get this sense like, wow. I get a wow sense like, wow. This is what I really want. This has freed me from the, any necessity for any alignments at all. I don't need alignments. I am bliss. I don't need alignments. I am bliss. I am free. Alignments are not a necessity. I am bliss. I am free. Alignments are not a necessity. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and alignments are nothing. I am bliss, and alignments are nothing. I am bliss, and alignments are nothing. Bliss and alignments are nothing. I am bliss, I'm alignment free. I'm exactly as God created me. I am bliss, I am alignment free, exactly as God created me. I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am bliss, and alignments are nothing. I am bliss, I am free, alignments have no necessity. Sounds like a chopper. I am bliss, and alignments are nothing. I am, and time isn't. I am, and time isn't. I am bliss, alignments are nothing. I am bliss, I am free, alignments have no necessity. I am in bliss, alignments are nowhere. I am in bliss, and alignments are nowhere. The feeling of bliss is perfectly sound, and alignments are nowhere to be found. The feeling of bliss is perfectly sound, and alignments are nowhere to be found. feeling of bliss is perfectly sound, and alignments are nowhere to be found. The feeling of bliss is perfectly sound, and alignments are nowhere to be found. Now, if any of you have the time, if you want to help out, you can, like, in the comment section, you can write down these declarations that have been given out in this video. Because I can't remember them all. There's a lot. I don't have the time to go through it all, necessarily. A lot of responsibilities and doing these tapings is most important. But if you'd like to, you can go through and, out of this video, take all the declarations that have been made, and then type them up in the comment section so we all know, can remember what they are. I don't remember what they are. These are all spontaneous. I don't know. I don't remember. I'm just on to the next one. But that'd actually be quite helpful, I believe, for us. Because then others could see that and say, look at all these great declarations. Yeah, let's make a book of declarations as such. So again, feel free to do that. Feel free to do that. And just post them in the comment section, and then when you run out of space, make another comment and post some more, make another comment, just that kind of thing. You can have a little program where you listen and you type in the declarations and then copy and paste into the comment section for us, which would be really cool. Feel free to help out in that way. That would be helpful. I am bliss. Adjustments are nothing. I am bliss, and adjustments are nothing. I am, and time isn't. That's always a good one. I am, and time isn't. So there's a wealth of declarations here. I can't remember any at the moment. But there's that one. I am and time isn't. That's easy to remember. I am and time isn't. I am bliss. I am free. Need no time, no adjustments for me. I am bliss, I am free, need no time, no adjustments for me, no alignments for me. I am time, I am bliss, I am free, don't need time, no alignments for me. I am bliss, I am free, alignments are totally unnecessary for me. I am bliss, I am free, alignments are totally unnecessary for me. There you go. I am bliss, I am free, alignments are totally unnecessary for me. I am bliss, I am free, alignments are totally unnecessary for me. I am bliss, alignments are nothing. I am bliss, time is nothing. I'm in bliss, time is nowhere. I am in bliss, alignments are nowhere. I am alignments, I am bliss, I am free, alignments are totally unnecessary for me. I am bliss, I am free, alignments are totally unnecessary for me. How do I feel now? I can feel this effect, profound effect, no question about it. The wow effect, a reverberation. I am bliss, and time is nothing. That's a powerful one. I am, and time isn't. Or I am bliss, and time is nothing. Carries a profound reverberation. It's like hitting the bell. Boom! You know, like that. So when the bell gets rung during this declaration time, during this dance of declaration that we're doing, your bell will get rung most likely, and you'll feel the reverberation. All you need to do is just sit there quietly. Don't seize upon it. Don't even have to observe it carefully or anything. You're not trying to get anything out of it. The bell's rung, it's rung. That's it. It's already rung. Can't be unrung. So you don't need to observe it real carefully. Like, okay, what's happening now? Where's the reverberation? Where's all this? No, forget it. It's just rung. It's been rung. And so you just kind of say, that's great. That's great. Just let it reverberate. My bell's been rung, that's really great. All I need to do is just let it reverberate. See, my bell has been rung, that's really great. Now I just let it reverberate. There's another one, another declaration. My bell has been rung, that's really great. All I need to do is just let it reverberate. My bell's been rung, that's great, let it reverberate. I am bliss and time is nothing. My bell has been rung, that's really great, and now I just let it reverberate. No need to think, okay, how is that going to change my alignment? You know, what are my alignments going to be like? No, don't even think about it. Just let it reverberate. It's reverberating on its own. All these overtones, everything's just reverberating on its own. It's like, imagine striking a bell. Boom. You don't need to do anything. The bell's doing it. The bell's doing the reverberation. You just sit there and just listen to it. Just feel a reverberation, that's all. Don't try to get into it. Don't make a mental effort to get into it. It's the reverberation is, you know, it's already there. It's having its effect. Don't worry. Don't worry about it. Get back to declarations. I am bliss and time is nothing. I am bliss and alignments are nothing. I am bliss and alignments are nothing. I am bliss, I am free, alignments have no necessity. I am bliss, I am free, time has no necessity. I am bliss, I am free, the lessons of time have no necessity for me. I am time, I am perfectly free, the lessons of time have no necessity for me. I am, time isn't. I am, time isn't. I am, time isn't. I am, time isn't. I am bliss, I am free, I am exactly as God created me. I'm in bliss, and alignments are nowhere. I am in bliss, and time is nowhere. I am bliss and time is nothing. I am bliss and time is nothing. I am, time isn't. So these are intensives. I would say right now that intensives are helpful. So, yeah, let us the dance of declaration. Intensives are helpful. When we put forth a burst of effort to ring the bell, really ring the bell. And then let it reverberate. And then gather our strength again, and then go back for another intensive, that type of thing. some, maybe every time the bell gets rung more and more, dong, bong, 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 you know, and it's like gradually just the whole, just reverberating with it. I am blessed, time is nothing. I am blessed, time is nothing. Ah, it's back. It just froze.
Alignments are nothing. I am in bliss. Alignments are nowhere. I am in bliss and alignments are nowhere. I am in bliss and alignments are nowhere. So, when in your life you've always, maybe you've always had this goal. Say, I want to be enlightened. I really want to be enlightened. I want to be self-realized. I want to be free of suffering, etc. We're right there. This is really, I can feel, this is really on the verge of it, actually. Feeling this. I am in bliss and alignments are nowhere. We are literally moving into enlightenment. When we say this, when we do this dance of declaration, we are literally ringing our bell to familiarize ourselves, to deal with the continuity issue of being enlightened. Enlightenment has no alignment. There are no alignments in enlightenment. There are no alignments in enlightenment. I'm enlightened. I don't need alignment. Now that I'm enlightened, I don't need any alignment. I've always been enlightened. I've never needed an alignment. Again, say that. I've always been enlightened. I've never needed alignment. I've always been enlightened. I've never needed alignments. I've always been enlightened. I've never needed alignment. All right, here's another one. Very good. I've always been enlightened. I've never needed alignments. I've always been enlightened. I have never needed alignments. I've always been enlightened. I've never needed alignment. I've never needed alignment because I've always been enlightened. What I am has always been enlightened. I've never needed any alignments. I am enlightened. I need no alignments. Alignments are nothing. I am enlightened. I need no alignments. Dance of declaration. So we're entering into a new dance. We have a new dance partner. New dance partner is declarations. That's our new dance partner. We're entering into a new dance. As time begins to dance its dance of destabilization, we're dancing our dance of declarations. And you can feel like, hey, this dance is this is the way I'm supposed to dance. This is the way I'm supposed to dance. I was born to dance this way. I wasn't born to dance with alignments and destabilization. I'm not here to do that. I'm not here to dance the dance of destabilization. I'm here to dance the dance of declaration. I am bliss and alignments are nothing. Maybe we need to do these marathon dances. Really, we're at that time.
I wouldn't be surprised if the world starts getting into marathon dancing, if time doesn't get into that. It wouldn't be surprising at all. There have been various times when troubles arise that people get into dancing. The dancing, dance marathons used to be a big, big, big thing. Various times in the world that has happened. I wouldn't be surprised at all if people start getting into that, trying to align themselves with time more and more. Where I wouldn't be surprised if we get into declaration marathons, dance of declaration marathons. We have a different dance partner, not alignment, but declarations, not destabilization, but declarations. When the Native American Indians were totally destabilized, their entire culture, entire civilization was completely destabilized. Totally destabilized, you see. They got into what's called ghost dancing. And they would dance and dance and dance and dance and dance until they completely dropped unconscious. And then they'd be woken up and dance some more. Basically trying to dance themselves to death. Ghost dancing. Trying to align themselves with, realign themselves with the quote-unquote Great Spirit. They felt that somehow they had gotten out of alignment with the Great Spirit and they needed to get in alignment. If they just did this dancing of alignment, trying to align dances or all sorts of kind of alignment exercises and physical alignment, and they're trying to align with the Great Spirit, they can do that, then this destabilization will vanish. You know, they will gain the upper hand of stability. Of course, it didn't work. But what works is the dance of declarations. That's what actually works. I am bliss, and all alignments are nothing. So, I wouldn't be surprised if we get in a marathon with that, a dance marathon of declarations. At some point, it may become very necessary, as a matter of fact. Very necessary. Very possible. Because the destabilization that's coming up is severe. Could be quite, quite severe. And people will say, I need to do something. I feel I need to make an all-out effort at this point. Anything less is insufficient. And at that point, people may want to have a declaration marathon, declaration dance marathon. And just continuous 24 hours a day. Continuous. Yeah, I hope a Ustream could be used for something like that, but I'm having these connectivity problems. So how do you do it live around the world? Well, I'll see what I can do, but that could very well take place. And you can just participate as long as you want. We'll see what happens. I don't know what's going to happen, but that is certainly within the realm of possibility. Because again, people will maybe suddenly feel a need to just go all in. You know, I say, yeah, I need to spend all my time with something. I need to commit and spend all my time on it. I cannot keep parsing it out here and there. I need to really focus and commit. And they'll say, come on, more and more and more. We want more and more and more and more and more. Very great. So we've put in a couple hours here, which is always great. Always good to have a couple hours. And I'm going to, I guess, go get something to eat. The reverberation is mellowed out a little bit. So we will do that. It's great to share these efforts with you, and we certainly need this type of effort in the world right now. Because remember, I am bliss, and time is nothing. I am, and time isn't. I am, and time isn't. Very great. That's it for this one.